Let us discuss two more questions based on capacitor. This question number one is conceptual question, which says a parallel plate capacitor is charged to a potential difference V and then disconnected. If the distance between plate is doubled, state the reason how the following will change: capacitance, electric field between plates, potential difference, and energy stored. Right? Now remember two things which I told you earlier also. When you charge capacitor with a certain potential source V, and after charging if you disconnect it, then charge across the capacitor remains constant. Potential will change. If, second case, if capacitor remains connected with a potential difference supply or source, then potential difference will be constant. On the basis of these concepts, you can solve it. Since here potential difference is disconnected, so Q will be constant. Now capacitance is equal to what? Capacitance is equal to epsilon naught A dy to d, right? And question says the separation distance is doubled, so d is doubled. It means new capacitance is half of first capacitance, right? Put d is equal to 2d. Electric field between plates, electric, first see potential difference. Potential difference is Q over C. Charge remains constant. So new dash, new potential will be Q over C dash. Capacitance has become half. Charge is constant. So this is becoming half. It means potential difference is 2V. Yes? This is becoming C by 2. So 2 goes up. So it is 2V. Then electric field is equal to V over D. Now electric field is how much? 2V. This has become new electric field, new potential difference, new D. That is 2V by 2D. Electric field does not change. Right? Then what is there? Energy stored. Energy stored is equal to half CV square. C is half. It has become C by 2. V is doubled, that is 4V square. So this is half CV square into 2. So U dash becomes twice of V. I hope it is clear. Now second question, this is NCERT question 2.27. capacitor of 4 microfarad is charged to 200 volt supply. It is disconnected and connected to another capacitor of 2 microfarad. Calculate common potential formula. Solution, have a look. Common potential is equal to what? C1V1 plus C2V2 over C1 plus C2. C1 is how much? 4 microfarad into voltage is 200 into 10 raised to power minus 6. V2 is 0, so plus 0, divided by 4 plus 2 into 10 raised to power minus 6. This cancels, 10 raised to power minus 6. So how much is left? 800 divided by 6. So what is your answer? 400 by 3 volt. Right? Therefore, change in energy you can calculate. that is you can say half C1 V1 square. Energy for second capacitor is 0, this is initial energy, minus half C1 plus C2 VC whole square. VC whole square means this is how much? If you calculate, comes out 8. When you put up the value of VC here, common potential you know. So you can say 8 minus half C1 plus C2 is 6 microfarad. VC is 400 by 3 whole square. When you calculate this, this comes out 5.3 into 10 raised to the power minus 2. This also is 10 raised to the power minus 2 whole. So it comes out 2.67 into 10 raised to the power minus 2 joules. Listen me carefully. So across these two points you have 100 volt. Now 100 picofarad is this, 100 picofarad is this. So it means it will equally divide this C1 and this arm. It will have same potential difference because these are in parallel. Listen it again. This is C1, this is C2, this is C3. Potential difference across this is 100. So C1 will carry 100, this arm will carry 100. So V1 will be equal to 100 volt. There are two capacitors in series, so you can find, say, equally divided. So V2 is equal to 50 volt, V3 is equal to 50 volt. Like this you can find easily Q2, Q1, that is C1 into V1. 100 into 10 raised to power minus 12 into voltage is 100. So it is 10 raised to the power minus 8. Q2 you can also find, that is 50 into volt capacitance is 200 picofarad, 10 raised to power minus 12. This will be 10,000, so it is 10 raised to the power minus 8. Is it okay? And then Q3 will also be equal to same. No, check it again. 100 volt V1 across this, 100 volt, so 100 into 10 raised to the power minus 12 C1 into 100, 10 raised to power 4, 10 raised to power minus 8 coulomb. This is 50 volt into 200, so it is again 10,000, 10 raised to power minus 8 coulomb. Q3 will also be equal to the same because it has same potential and same capacitance. So it's a wonderful question. It revises your series and parallel combination and good answer. two more NCERT numerical problem. Question number 2.15. A spherical conducting cell of inner radius R1 and outer radius R2 has a charge Q. This cell is carrying charge Q. A charge small q is placed at the center of the shell. It is here. What will be the surface charge density of inner and outer cell? So this charge which is placed on inner cell, this will induce negative charge on the inner cell, inner part of the cell. Eventually this will induce positive charge plus small q on the outer cell. So solution: surface charge density of inner cell will be equal to what? I can say sigma 1 charge is minus q divided by area 4 pi r1 square. Now outer cell is carrying surface charge density of outer cell sigma 2 is equal to q plus q over 4 pi r2 square, right? So first part is done. Now second part, what does it says? If this cell is in irregular shape, will the electric field within the cavity will be zero? Answer is yes. Choose any closed loop inside and outside the cavity like this, right? And this should be parallel to the direction of electric field. Then calculate work done in a loop, and work done in a loop you will find it is zero. This shows electric field is zero because work done is equal to E dot dx. X cannot be zero because we have assumed a loop, and since we have taken direction of the loop in the direction of electric field, so cos theta, theta is 0, that is also not 0, it is a 1. Second question is 2.28. So that the force on each plate of the parallel plate capacitor is half QE, where Q is the charge, E is electrostatic field between the two plates. Let's see how can we do this question. We know energy density. How do we define energy density? U over V, that is work done over volume. Work done is how much? F into delta X. Then what was the answer? Epsilon naught E square into volume. Now see, F delta X half epsilon naught E square, volume is A into delta X, where delta X is the separation distance. Then this cancels. You can put, now we use E is equal to V over D also. So F is equal to half epsilon naught V over D. A I am bringing inside. Perfect. And V is still, E is still left outside. I have made this E into two parts. E is put up as V over D and E is kept still outside because I need this E in the result. Now see, half epsilon naught A D this is what? C. CV into E. C into V by definition is what? Sorry. Epsilon naught A over D is C. So half CVE and CV is what? Q, so QE. I repeat it again, epsilon naught A over D is C, half is kept as such, V is brought as such, E is there, C into V is Q, so it is half QB. Let's see two more examples while we are using dielectric slab in between parallel plates of the capacitors. Consider two cases. Case number one, this is a parallel plate capacitor. Separation distance is D and two dielectric slabs are introduced, dividing capacitor into two halves. Another is of dielectric constant K2. One is K1, another is K2. How do we find effective capacitance of this capacitor? See, this is positive, so on dielectric surface in this side will be negative. This side of K1 will be positive, this side of K2 will be negative, this side of K2 will be positive, and then obviously negative is charge on the plate. Right? Now this you can consider as an example of two capacitors. Only the thing which we have to see whether they are connected in series or parallel. So check it out what is happening. Positive of one capacitor is connected with negative, positive is connected with negative, and this is being done in series combination. So C1 will be equal to K1 epsilon naught A over D by 2, that is 2 K1 epsilon naught A over D. Similarly, C2 you can write equals to 2 K2 epsilon naught A over D. Now for series, what is your formula? 1 over C equivalent is equal to 1 over C1, 1 over C2. So when you put it there, you will have D over 2 epsilon naught A common. And what you will have in the bracket? 1 over K1, 1 over K2. Right, this will come down, this will go up. So solve this. What you will have, 1 over C equivalent is equal to D 2 epsilon naught A. Here you will have K1 K2, here you will have K1 plus K2. So C equivalent is equal to 2 epsilon naught A, A over D, K1, K2 divided by K1 plus K2. Is it right? Two epsilon naught A D 1 over K1 plus 1 over K2 K1 K2. So when you revert it, K1 plus K2, yes. So yes, now let's see another case quickly. In this case, we have divides like this, K1, K2. Now here, separation distance is same, area of cross section is half, negative, positive, negative. So these are in parallel. So C1 is equal to K1 epsilon naught A over D. C2 is equal to K2 epsilon naught A over D. Therefore, using parallel combination, C equivalent is equal to C1 plus C2. This is area is half, so 2D. Area is half. We are going here. So this is epsilon naught A over 2D, you can take common, K1 plus K2. Right? That's how you can do questions of dielectrics lab also.